Here we go, Alexander Dara wins the die roll, fetches down to 19. And plays Deathrite Shaman. Mm-hmm. And he gets Beautiful Bayou.
Yeah.
Saw that all his basic lands, I think, were beta or alpha.
Yeah.
Yeah. Basic lands, dual lands, I mean, sorry.
Yeah.
It went... his opponent is playing White Pointed Plains.
Yeah.
I don't know which one it is. Never seen it. Looks good. Swords of Plowshares on that right. Always a good play.
So he's back at 20.
Yeah. There we go.
If he doesn't force this... Nope. It's exiled, so... I hope Alexander doesn't forget to turn his white die to remind us his life total.
Yeah, like I said, he might be missing some few there. Maybe Thomas Lenz can help us out. why is he at... Now the die is wrong. Is it 19?
Yeah, he fetched his first planes.
Okay.
With a flooded strand, so...
Ponder into Force of Will. What else?
So two mainstream decks. Shaki, what do you think? Who's got the edge in this matchup?
Let's have a... That's not a mainstream deck that Lance Thomas is playing, in my opinion. It's a mix of a Planeswalker Gideon style deck, because he plays one Gideon of the Trials, two Gideon of Ally of Zendikar, one Humility, a main deck Engineered Explosive, two Back to Basics, Chase the Mind Sculptor, and the rest seems like a miracle start, but no predicts, no portent. No portent. He even plays a Crucible of Worlds.
Okay, for the Wastelands maybe?
Yeah, three Wastelands, so it's not a Miracles list. I put Blue-Eyed Control, Blue-Eyed Planeswalkers, but it's a hybrid. But he is 3-1 with it, so I think he must be on the right path.
Yeah.
Sideboard is also more control. Meddling Mages, Containment Priest, Another Humility, Supreme Verdict, Search for Ascanta, all answers.
There's a him the Tuark, is being countered.
By a force. So he's at 18 now.
So. Yeah.
Deciding on the blue card. To remove.
No, he already pitched a Snapcaster. Alexander is thinking of countering the Force of Will, so
there you go.
Pitching a Leovold, so he must be...
The cat is out of the bag. If it wasn't already with the Hymn to Turek, of course. I'm just gonna choose to.
Yeah.
Let's see. Scalding Tarn.
And Humility, I think.
Yeah. That's good information.
Yeah, indeed.
By the way, the backup match is two of our friends playing.
Yeah,
it's Seth Van Doorn and Ilya Berikov.
Seth Van Doorn, of course, the owner of our
sponsor shop, The Colonist, as you can see in the bottom left hand side. Look, beautiful dual lands.
Wasteland on the volcanic.
Alexander. Chase, Ponder. Couldn't see the last one, or the first one he drew.
I think it's Gulligan's Command. Let's see. Yeah, I think so. And that's right.
Okay. Right comes down, survives the turn or not. Thomas Lenz is thinking.
It's a first main phase of Alexander already. So
he just made a land drop and said go.
Yeah, he did.
Also, two very experienced players, also very fast pace of play.
Yeah,
only when it's untimed and the extra turns, I can understand that it's going to the wire. You need to be a little bit more a shuffle from the Ponder. Mm-hmm. Well, I think that's good because he didn't have a fetch land. He brainstormed and he put some bad cards back. So if the one he didn't see yet, that he didn't put back or drew back, isn't very, very, very good, then shuffle is needed. So
He had drawn the Ponder, so the top card was Ponder. So he drew that off this turn, knowing if he
didn't see a good card,
he can shuffle below, the,
or two cards deep, because that's good sequencing. A lot of people would first Ponder, then see, oh, this is not good, shuffle their deck, and then maybe hope for a fetch. But that's not good, because if you don't hit the fetch and you're stuck with a Brainstorm,
you can be stuck for two turns, so...
Yeah, your value goes down too much. Wasteland, two of the three Wastelands already found.
Yeah.
Well, I can tell you, I like the control matchup here, because Humility wrecks all their creatures. Leovold, Deadrite, and so on. But the Crucible makes it so that the whole mana base can be destroyed, except for one island and one swamp.
Yeah. That's
and
true.
When you're playing a five-color deck, that's not good.
No. No.
Because then you're playing your Baleful Strixes and they do nothing.
We see already one Humility in the...
only plays one main deck.
Ah, he only plays one.
One more on the side.
Okay.
But he has other shenanigans, like I said, Gideon of the Trials, Crucible of Worlds, Engineered Explosives, pretty good as well. Gideon... I have Zendikar. Also another main deck, he has two back to basics.
Okay.
So I think game one, although he lost a Tyrol, normally Thomas Lenz should be favored.
Yeah.
But he got him to Turecht. But in, he also drew two Wastelands, thus Counterspell, Ice Age version, nice. Yeah.
Beautiful.
It's good to see Counterspell coming back in. It's been gone for so long.
Yeah.
And with the Miracles being nerfed a little bit with the Sensei's Divining Top and then coming back stronger than before, I like that it's back.
Yeah.
So, in the meantime, the land was removed from the graveyard. Yeah. So, Alexandre Dara is up to speed that there is a Crucible option in this list.
Yeah.
Otherwise, he would not get rid of those lands for no reason.
Yeah.
So, very heads up play. He drew a swamp, of course, right after fetching for an island. But yeah, he's pretty happy with that. Or, and then, that's a swamp. So now he has everything kind of under control. Humility's gone, Wastelands, except for one, is gone.
Yeah.
And
now we can start attacking.
Just making the drops, the land drops, until. Probably a back to basics. Yeah, he's back to basics safe pretty much as well. He has his two basics.
Yeah.
Does he? And he has Abrupt Decay. Yeah, he can't cast Abrupt Decay unless he leaves his Bayou untapped. Money does he have?
But as long as the Deathrite is active, he can
make mana.
Yeah, he can waste. He can remove all the lands from his own graveyard.
He isn't too fussed with that. Another I think he's at 14. Sorry, a little late with the life adjustment. And I think Alexander is at 18 indeed, because he already fetched twice.
Yeah.
Ponder Force, Colligan's Command, Bolt. Colligan's Command goes back. And the one card I didn't see.
He can only make red mana with his Deathrite Shaman, so...
Yep. Until he finds a second Volcanic or the Badlands.
Yeah.
Black.
Yeah, now we can...
Do you have... Okay, the counterspell goes down to 12.
And the blow on the Deathrite. How valuable do you think it is, Alexander?
Two cards from your hand for a Ponder. You better have some good cards on top.
He knows the top cards because he pondered last turn.
Mm-hmm,
so
and kept them. There is a Colligan's Command there.
Yeah.
And an unknown card, unknown to me. So he has to keep his Deathrite alive. Goes down to 17 life, I'm presuming.
Half of the graveyard is off the camera, so...
Oh no, he stays at 18 because he gains... Oh no, he has to go to 17, sorry. Yeah. Because he doesn't gain life. Half the graveyard off screen.
Yeah.
Another hit from Snappy. He drew the call against command, yeah.
Yeah.
But, it's weird if he knows the call against command is coming, why he wouldn't... Ah, he has no red mana.
Yeah.
So he couldn't get the death right back and discard the opponent's card one.
No.
So, yeah, he has no red mana. He really needs it. I'll get the blow. No. I'll get the land. I'm gonna cast Culligan's Command, or what? Yeah,
I think so. Some
is
discard.
There something he can get back? Or is he gonna shoot?
Yeah.
Shoot you, discard, or did he already lose a creature? Because Leovold and the Death Rider exiled.
Yeah.
And Leovold he can't get back anyway.
Snapcaster?
Even further off the screen. His opponent discarded the force, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
So down to 8 he goes.
So Thomas, just on 4 lands, that's not where you want to go with a control deck.
No. His opponent is on 3 lands, but he has active death right, so that makes all the difference.
Yeah.
He's lost some of his key pieces already. Snapcaster targeting something black-green.
I'm not sure if...
he's just putting up the clock or what. Yeah.
I'm not sure if...
Brainstorm off of the blue mana made from the death right.
Maybe he had Supreme Verdict in hand, but misses the second white mana source.
Supreme Verdict is in a sideboard.
There's one in this. He has one in this main board.
Okay. I'm sorry about the silence there for a moment. I was discussing with Ivo to ask if Alexandre Dara can put the graveyard on screen, because it's pretty important in this matchup. And we couldn't see what he got back from Culligan's Command and so on. And you scooped over a little bit to the left, so maybe now we can see what's going on a little bit more clear. Let's see if the backup match is underway quickly. Yeah, they're playing. Don't know if it's 1-1 or 0-1 for somebody. Ilya Berkov on the left playing Eldrazi. And Seb van Doorn playing the Robo Rallyers, the Robo deck Steel Stompy. So we're going to watch this match a little bit whilst the other match is on the way. Steel Stompy, we've seen it in the hands of Johan de Gruyter earlier today. Very, very new deck. Very potent deck. So Seb van Doorn on his side of the battlefield at the moment has a City of Traitors Ancient Tomb. He has an Arcbound Ravager on the bottom and a Lotus Petal. Beautiful masterpieces. Lotus Petal and a Mox Opal. And then I think a Ratchet Bomb and also Karn Sign of Urza on 6 with one card underneath it. And Ilya has a Walking Ballista on 2 with 2 Ancient Tombs. The life totals I can't see because Ilya's is off screen. Seb is on 18, it seems, if they are correct. We can't vouch for that. He just played an Inventor's Fair. Has to sacrifice the City of Traitors for that. So that's... not really a cause of concern at the moment because his board state is very good. He has Metalcraft, so the Mox Opal taps for anything. And if need be, he can always sacrifice a petal or something. Hey, thank you, Evo. The die is on 15, so the life totals are 15-18 on this match. Once again, this is not the feature match of table 5. We're playing today Legacy Tournament, and we're playing 6 rounds of Swiss, and then a cut to top 8. We'll bring you everything up until the final as much as we can, unless the matches finish early, of course. And Sepp van Doorn is deep in the tank, thinking on what he wants to do with his board state. Ilya patiently waiting. I see something very nice in Sepp van Doorn's list. Something new from Dominaria that's not Skarn, Urza Sion. Namely, Traxxas, the Scourge of Krug.
Maybe you can put it on the screen for our viewers.
Do you know it? Have you seen it before?
No.
No, Traxxas is beautiful for this deck. It's a 7/7 trample for 4 mana. And it comes into play tapped and never untaps. Unless you play something called a historic spell. And those are artifacts, legendary sagas are historic. Yeah, it's a steel stompy deck. Yeah. So it untaps almost immediately. So yeah, 4 mana, 7/7 trample.
That's not a bad
thing. Sniff at.
Not a bad thing.
Nope. Indeed. The feature table number 1 is still cutting decks. They're drawing opening hands, so we're going back there. Maybe this match is still going on after this one finishes. We will return to it if possible. I see Force of Will Brainstorm.
I see a Mulligan.
Yeah.
Pretty fast, so yeah. Must be an easy decision.
Thomas Lenz is thinking a little longer about his hand. Tundra. Brainstorm, can't tell anything different from it. Very important round, by the way, because I think if you have a win here, you can ID in the last round to be in top 8.
I was just entering the hall, and I saw that the first 2 players already ID'd.
That's Dries van Heukelam, I believe. He was 4-0. And is it Johan de Gruyter and Dylan Bottom?
Yeah, oh,
okay.
Johan de Gruyter.
So a steel stomp in the top 8, definitely already.
Yeah.
I don't really know what Dylan Bottom is playing. I haven't seen him play yet.
Not sure as well.
The other 12 is Dries van Heukelam.
So we have 3 players on
12 points.
3 players on 12 points. So I think Dries couldn't have ID'd because his opponent has to play.
Yeah, Joris van Hol has to play. Remember, we had Dries on stream with Goblins in round 1, destroying Big Eldrazi. And he's been rampaging all day with Goblins.
Grinding through the field.
Here we go, Thoughtseize. After Tundra, go. Counterspell, Chase, Humility. Plow, path. So path to exile came in from the side. Probably the second Humility came in from the side.
Yeah.
Rest in peace probably came in from the side for Thomas Lenz. Meddling Mage, perhaps. Don't know if there's anything you can name that's... Yeah, so diverse. Removal suites and disruption. So.
Yeah. So 17.
Yeah.
After our fetch and 2 from the Thoughtseize.
He takes the counterspell. Yeah. Different counterspell than before.
Yeah.
And a Misty Rainforest comes down. Fetch down to 16 with the Polluted Delta from Alexander Daira. We didn't really see much from Thomas Lenz's deck in game 1, to be honest. Just reactive and losing a lot of cards to hand disruption.
I think his mana base was too...
crimp too tight.
Yeah, to really get his thing going on, what his deck is supposed to be doing.
Yeah.
So
him to Turak.
Yeah.
After the counterspell takes the Thoughtseize.
Yeah.
That's gonna be very bad. Very, very bad for the control deck. I'll just take these two. So, Jace. Can I have my cards back, please? And a plow. Oh, yeah. Gone.
So,
I think Alexander wants a quick one because he has been playing a long game this round before. This round, and he's up 1-0. I think he can deserve a little break.
Maybe he's hungry.
Yeah, I understand that.
And stay hydrated. If you play 6-7 rounds, and if you play top 8, you gotta stay hydrated.
And it's very warm in the hall. The ventilation's been on all day, but it's still very warm. Definitely, I've been told by Matthias Dille and Maarten Verbeek, this table, the feature table, it's underneath the tent to get the lighting a little bit okay for the mats.
Yeah.
Especially with reflecting glare on the sleeves and the foils.
Yeah.
And it's very hot. I told him, we don't get a fan in our bunker, so you don't get a fan on your table.
Yeah.
He had to laugh, of course. Liliana, the last hope. Pluses. Yeah, there's no target, but you can still plus.
Plays two of them, one in his main deck and two. One in his main deck and one in his sideboard, so maybe he sided it in.
I think he must side it in because it answers humility very easily.
Yeah.
It's a big target for an engineered explosives. It can't be disenchanted. Supreme Verdict. Although Pitting Needle, there's a one-off in the side that can ruin its day, but yeah. Is Thomas Lenz missing land drops? Or is he...
He's
missing land drops because he's on the play. Pander, counter this. He's missing land drops. Ooh. Yeah. No counter spell available or not worthy to force? Not worthy to force, of course not. He's already one land drop behind, probably. Alexander thinks that's okay for me.
Think you just want to counter the
humility or whatever comes off. Yeah, humility wouldn't do anything now, but anything that threatens the Liliana in play. Up another land drop with Alexander Dumas. The Dara, it's very good for him to keep making those. That's what I said, all the beautiful tool lands.
Yeah.
Jace. What are we doing with Jace? Jace and Liliana. It's gonna be a big, big combo knockout, I think. Yeah. Alexander should be at 16 with a die, so that's why the overlays change.
Not sure what he's going to do. I think Brainstorm with the... Yeah. Brainstorm.
He has a fetch available.
Yeah.
Maybe he can get rid of a worse card than Ponder at this moment if he wants to force.
Mm.
The kill will come probably from Liliana anyway. Or the concession from his opponent. There we go. The six. At the same time, he kept the Ponder, so there wasn't a better blue cards for him to find to get rid of if he should force. He fetches down to 15, but doesn't adjust the die. I'll just change the board myself. Thomas Lenz waiting.
Plow on the Deathrite Shaman, gaining one life. He's back at 16. And the fetch, so he's down to 19. Let's see, that's a fort land. Not quite sure for playing his own chase. So maybe he can force this. Alexander, yes, two cards in hand, a force of will and the blue card. So no chase.
But for Thomas Lenz.
Alexander is down to 15, one life for the force of will.
Okay. And Thomas Lenz is... He was at 19 from a fetch, I believe.
Yeah, I fetched.
I think they're playing so concentrated that... or focused that they... Now upping the chase, putting the screws on Thomas Lenz. Yeah. Leaves it on top. Has no fetches to get rid of the bad card. And passes the turn back. Liliana is going to ultimate soon.
Yeah.
Maybe, Cancel's Judgment in time. I was thinking Cancel's Judgment or Unexpectedly Absent. I think you can use that one too.
Chooses the Liliana, of course.
I think Alexander also chooses the Liliana.
Yeah.
Yeah, he also has an answer in Unexpectedly Absent and putting Needle from the side now.
Yeah.
It's only a temporarily, but it can really wreck someone's day. If somebody fetches, you can put it somewhere in the deck, resolves, and it's gone.
So
Chase keeps sticking up, keeps putting the card on top. Still no fetches for Thomas Lenz. And would have been a while, Chase Ultimate.
Yeah. Would have been nice if we couldn't get it on camera.
I don't think we've had one on camera ever. Usually players concede before it can.
Yeah.
It's never played out.
Yeah.
It's too devastating. Rest in peace. Yeah, okay. I don't think that's Alexander's plan this game. Pyroblast, more protection.
Yeah.
Chase, 9. So let me see that card. It goes back on top. I'm not afraid of that.
No. If your opponent has a fetch land in play, and you are playing Chase, Jackie, and you see a...
And he puts it on top.
And you fade seal and you put it on top.
You can bluff, yeah.
Would you do it? Would you consider it?
I would do it like once in 3 times or something. Because if he decides it's a 50-50 and I decide it's 33% chance that he catches me, then I'm still
ahead.
Yeah. And
Okay.
If he sees it once, I will change.
Okay.
I will change from 1 in 3, depending on behavior and facial expression on.
Yeah.
But I would definitely try 1 in 3 times.
That's your humility.
Humility.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. Nope. Gets by Chase. Bonner. Yeah, okay. Chase will ultimate next turn. As long as there is no unexpectedly absent and so on.
Does he play a red elemental blast?
Hydro blast. Red, he can't play a red elemental blast because it's blue-white control.
Okay.
Jace's ultimate is minus 12, so...
He doesn't play red. Okay, because he had a Scalding Tarn, maybe I thought he would have played some red.
Well, he plays a Misty, 2 Scaldings, a Polluted, maybe to set people off. Like I said, it's a hybrid, brewish kind of deck.
Or it's just to...
Make people think it's something else, sneak attack or something. Sneak and show, if you play Scalding Tarns and fetch for... Or so threaten some cards, like from the sideboard.
Yeah.
But I don't see any, so... He fetches the Tarn. Goes down to 18.
Yeah.
And
I think
Chase Ultimate is gonna happen. He's on 13. So if there was ever a time to go Unexpectedly Absent, or Cancel's Judgment, white spells, because we know he has a red blast.
Yeah. I think there's a fly on our camera. You think?
A huge fly.
Hey, everybody wants to see magic.
Yeah. Like I said, it's pretty warm in that corner. So maybe the fly is attracted to the heat or something. Anyway, I think, I'm not sure. I've been premature in my conclusions. But I think,
That's
there we go.
Yeah.
Well, Alexander Dara, you can ID. I think 13 points will be enough.
Yeah.
Lance Thomas, you will probably not make it. 12 points, depending on the results above. But yeah, see, he had to have a white card to get rid of the Planeswalker. The second match is still very much in swing. Ilya and Seth Van Doorn, I will change the data. Let's see the live total, 16. And?
9.
And I'll change the names. Doorn, Seth.
We see a Spyglass on Ratchet Bomb and a Revoker on Arcbane Ravenger. And Kevin O'Sull's naming Eldrazi or Elemental. No, I think it's Eldrazi. It's upside down, so Sepp gained a life from his land. So he's on 10. Jackie?
Yeah. Like this.
Yeah.
Let me have a look. This
is there.
Done. This is Seb's list.
Okay.
There you go. And how many points did he have?
Let's see. Who's on?
Seb.
Seb is playing.
Both 6 points. So they're 2 and 2.
Yeah. Seb is counting the amount of damage that Ilya can do in the next turn. So we see a Thought Knots here.
So what was revoked, can you tell me?
Arcbane Ravager.
Arcbane Ravager, okay. Okay. Yeah, the Eldrazi Displacer and the Thought Knots here.
Yeah.
And are those different tokens? One is a Topter. The right one?
Yeah.
I think they're all Topters.
Yeah, but maybe the single one is
Summoning
6. So.
City of Traders. Yeah.
And passes his turn. And Eldrazi is in
Cavern.
Cavern of Souls is on Eldrazi, so.
I really like the cards, Evil. That's something new. Marker pen and the cards that we put on the table, it's gonna help us a lot.
Yeah.
Yesterday and today.
Yeah. In the past we used just a pen.
And a piece of paper.
Yeah.
But these thicker cards and a marker pen are a lot easier to recognize. Yeah. I'm going to displace a Topter, so it never comes back. Oh, it was a counter. It was a Topter with counters on it.
Okay.
Of course, that was possible with Steel Stompy.
With Steel
3-7 damage coming in. You want to block? I think.
At 10 life.
Yeah, you can block best.
Yeah.
You're going to lose a Topter anyway next turn, displacing. So you better just block now, because it's going to be displaced. Yeah. Oh, he takes it. Oh my god.
Okay, he's going to trigger.
Then he has another idea. He's going to get something from the Inventor's Fair. Tutoring.
Okay.
He taps Ancient Tomb, going down to 1. Mm-hmm. But it can look up a tutor's artifact. It's also one of the newer cards, not that new anymore. But I'll put it up. Legendary land. At the beginning of your upkeep, you control 3 or more artifacts. You gain a life, add a colorless, you tap it 4, and you sacrifice it. Search your library for an artifact card, reveal it, and put it in your hand, then shuffle your library. So it's a tutor for this deck, 4 mana tutor, which isn't hard with soul lands. Did you see what he got? I didn't see what he got.
No. That one. I'm not quite sure what it is.
A Snaring Bridge.
Okay, but...
I think. No, it's not a Snaring Bridge. We have this list. It's Champion, perhaps. Although it can't block colorless creatures. So I don't know.
So protection from... Viewers, help us out. Which card did Seb Van Doorn just played? We're watching the deck list right now. Just to make
it's
sure.
The masterpiece right next to the Darksteel Citadel in the middle of his playmat.
Yeah, and there's a handshake. I think it was
Ilya won?
Yeah. Not sure if it's 2-1 or